From Miami Beach to Maine, East Coast beaches are some of the most visited in the world. But just because they are popular doesn't mean they aren't hazardous.
If you want to keep your beach and ocean time fun and safe, you need to be aware of dangerous waves. And that starts by respecting the power of the ocean.
Even a small wave crashing against you has tremendous power. To smaller children, waves that may be only knee-high on an adult can be dangerous and traumatic. If you have young children, keep them close when you're in the water. Any breaking wave can be dangerous, but a wave breaking directly on a steep shore, like this one, is even more likely to cause serious injuries. These conditions are called shorebreak. Why is this type of wave so dangerous? Imagine the weight of a car pushing down on your head, neck, or back and pinning you against the sand. That is the impact a shorebreak wave can have and change your life forever. To understand dangerous waves, it's important to first understand what weather can do to waves. High winds from even distant storms can create larger, more threatening waves, even while the weather at your beach is sunny and calm. Another common danger you can find at any beach are waves driving you into hidden objects like shallow sandbars, jagged rocks, and debris. Before going into the water, ask a lifeguard or look for warning signs that may indicate submerged dangers.
The best way to always stay wave safe? Choose guarded beaches. Lifeguards are trained to help if you get into trouble, and they're the best source of information about beach conditions and hazards.
Many lifeguard stands display colored warning flags to indicate the level of danger on that section of beach. If the beaches in your area are not guarded, watch for warning signs near the shore and ask your local host or guides about hazards in the area that could make the waves and water more dangerous. But to be even safer, you should arrive knowing the local weather, surf, and tide forecast for the beach you're visiting. Go to NOAA's beach forecast page for more information.
Don't assume you know all the current hazards just because you regularly visit a certain beach. Weather and water conditions can change in minutes, and the tides are constantly changing.
Low tides create shallow water conditions where large waves crash over sandbars and submerged rocks, which can be dangerous if you don't see them. Watching the waves from higher up on the beach for up to 15 minutes will give you the best read on current conditions. Any size wave can look far less dangerous from the beach than they will feel once you are in the ocean. If things look even a little scary from shore, then swimming back to the beach can be worse. Even the most experienced ocean athlete knows, if in doubt, don't go out.
Now that you know how to be aware of conditions at the beach, let's talk about how to move in and out of the water so that you're not hurt by the power of the waves.
In knee to thigh deep water, turn your hips and shoulders sideways to keep your balance as you slice through the force of the waves with one foot planted behind you to brace against the wave. In water above your waist, the safest place is under and not over the white water of breaking waves. Face the oncoming wave and duck, don't dive, putting your head down and fingers in the sand below. If you are paddling, swimming, or walking back to the beach, never completely turn your back on the waves. Use the same method you use to get into the water as you return to the beach. You aren't safe until your feet are on dry sand. What if something happens to you or someone else? Keeping yourself safe while also helping others can save lives. When you see someone else in trouble and before you act, stay calm and practice what we call take 10. Pause to alert the lifeguards or someone on the beach and call 911. While help is coming, look for something that floats or will let you reach and assist the person in trouble while you stay safe. The most important action you can take is to protect yourself first so you don't become the tragic second victim.
We love all of our coastlines, and we want you to have a lifetime of great beach experiences. To have fun and stay safe, always respect the power of the ocean and be wave safe.
Before your feet hit the sand, Join us as we visit American coasts in the Ocean Today Wave Save series.